Hi all, welcome again to my channel. So today in this series of videos, I will discuss about graph data structure. So this is the very first video about graph data structure, and I will upload more videos one by one. So what is graph data structure? So graph data structure is a collection of nodes and edges. That means this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these are all called as nodes. And this node are connected by some line called edge. So a graph is a non-linear data structure consisting of nodes and edges. So these points like 1, 2, 3, they are known as node or vertex. That is another term for node. And they are connected by some line or maybe some relation that is known as edge. So graph is a combination of node and edge. So here if we see, I have total 5 vertices, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and total edges are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is 1, 2 is one edge, then 2, 3, 2, 5, then 3, 4, and 4, 5. So graph data structure is combination of vertices and edges. Now we will see what are some common areas or real life problems which we can solve using graph. So the telephone network. So any network system is a good example of graph, because there they have node or junction point, and from there the wires are going out and it can connect any other junction. Okay. And similar fashion circuit, any kind of circuit, complex circuit is an example of graph. Or paths in the city, because we have so many junction points, from there roads are going and crossing each other. So paths in a city is an example of graph. And we can consider metro stations also, like we have so many lines, blue line, red line, and they are crossing each other, then they are forming some junctions, and from there another station it is going. So that is all an example of graph. So in our social media site also, like Facebook and LinkedIn, there also we use graph. So here we can take an example of Facebook. Okay. So here I have defined few relations. So this Rohit is one person. He has some three friends, Sam, John and Ritu. And Sayan has friend as Amit and Rohit. Ritu has friend as Rohit, Sam and Sayan. So this relationship, if I maintain in graph, then it will be easy to understand and maintainability will be also easy. And when I will represent it as a graph, then so many other conclusions also we can draw easily by looking into the graph. So first what I will do, I will create node out of this friends or persons, whatever you can say. So Rohit is a node here, then I can take John, then Amit, Sam, Ritu and Sai. Then I can connect them if they have a relationship. So Rohit has friendship with Sam, means they are connected. Then Rohit has friendship with John also, they are connected. Then Ritu and Rohit, they are connected. Then Sayan has friendship with Amit. Then Sayan has friendship with Rohit also. Ritu has friendship with Rohit, Sam and Sayan. So Ritu and Rohit is already connected because Rohit was a friend of Ritu. Then Ritu have to connect with Sam. And Ritu have to connect with Sayan also. So now their full structure is ready. So this is their friendship graph, you can say. Now we can draw some conclusion from here. So if I ask you, like, who is the mutual friend between Ritu and Rohit? So by looking into this picture, we can easily tell, like, Sam and Sayan, both they are friend of Ritu and Rohit. So the Ritu and Rohit, the mutual friend between them is Sam and Sayan. So this is example of Facebook where relationships are maintained by friendship. Suppose there are some site like Instagram or Twitter. There the relationship is maintained by following, like who are follower of whom. So maybe I am follower of some big person, but it is not necessary that big person is also following me. Means there is some direction is there. So maybe Ritu is a follower of Rohit, But Rohit is not a follower of Prithu. That also we can maintain using graph. Those kind of graph is called like directed graph and all. That we will come later. Okay. And if we take example of Facebook, there only this friendship entity is not present. Apart from that also so many other things are there. Group, event, etc. etc. So many other things are also there. Suppose I have a group here in a Facebook group. Okay, travel group or some other channel, sports group. So there also some people, like some person which is actually a node, can connect with that. Suppose this group is followed by Sam, John, Rohit, then they can connect with this group. So those kind of relationship also we can easily maintain using graph. Now we have to know few terminology about graph. So one is adjacency. So what is adjacency? A vertex is said to be adjacent to another vertex if there is an edge connecting them. Okay, so 1 and 2, here if you see, there is a vertex, sorry, there is an edge present between 1 and 2. Okay, means they are adjacent to each other. Like that way, 0 and 1, there is an edge connecting both of them. That means they are adjacent. But if you see here, 1 and 3 is not connected by one edge. That means 1 and 3 is not adjacent. Like that way, 3 and 2 is also not adjacent. Next terminology is path. So what is path? A sequence of edges that allows you to go from vertex A to vertex B is called a path. Suppose I have to go from 1 to 3. I have to check, is there any route is there? Obviously a route is present. That is, from 1 to 0 we can go. Then from 0 to 3 we can go. So this is a path between 1 and 3. And this is not the only path present. So another path also we can traverse. From 1 to 2 we can go. Then 2 to 0. From 0 to 3. Obviously this route is shorter actually. So a path can be between these two elements also. Like from 1 to 2 this is the path. Or I can go to 1 to 2 from via 0 also. Okay. So a path is a sequence of edges that allows you to move from one node to another node. Now we have to know about few type of graph. Okay. So one is directed graph and undirected graph. So the example I was talking about you in the like Instagram or Twitter following part. So directed graph means in that graph with edge, the direction also will be provided. Means the direction is from 0 to 3. It has 1 to 0. So direction means maybe a road or maybe a relationship, anything. Okay. That means from 3 to 0 we can't move because the direction is from 0 to 3. Here if you see, from 1 to 2 also we can go, 2 to 1 also we can go. Okay. So that means it has two directional relationship between 1 and 2. And undirected graph means there actually no direction present in the edges. Next is weighted and unweighted graph. So weighted graph means where this edges will have some value. Suppose if you consider it as a road, suppose from 0 to 3 I have to go, maybe the distance is 7 km. That is the weight of this edge. Or maybe we can define some relationship also. Suppose how much strong bond is present between 0 to 3. Maybe the index is 7. They are getting some rating system maybe. Okay. So whenever the edge will have some value, that is known as the weight of the edge. Okay. So here if you see from 1 to 2, the weight it got was 5. Similar way from 0 to 1 it is 3 and 0 to 2 it is 4 and 0 to 3 it is 7. But here in this example, there is no weight given to the edge. So that is a unweighted graph. So now we have to know what is a complete graph. A complete graph is a graph in which each pair of graph vertices is connected by an edge. So in a simplest term, completed graph means where each and every node is connected to other node by one edge. Means we don't have to go via someone, we can directly go to any node. So from here actually I can go to any node. So like that way, in this picture, each node, from each node you can go to any other node by a single edge only. Okay. So that is known as a complete graph. Or else you can say that a complete graph is a graph where each possible edges are present. Next, what is connected graph? A graph is said to be connected if there is a path between every pair of vertex. From every vertex to any other vertex, there should be some path to traverse. That means here each and every nodes are connected. Means if I wish to go from one node to another node, there should be always one path present in case of connected graph. So I can move from anywhere to anywhere. If you tell to I have to go from 2 to 3, obviously a path is there. 2 to 0 we can go, from 0 to 3 we can go. Or maybe from 2 to 1, 1 to 0, 0 to 3 I can go. So from 3 to 1 I have to come. Then 3 to 0 we can go, from 0 to 1 I can go. So there is always a route present between each and every node. So that is known as connected graph. So each and every one is connected there. Suppose if a node is present 4, like 4, and there is no edge present between them or with anyone, then it is a disconnected graph, because there is no route to go from 1 to 4 or 0 to 4 like that way. So that is a disconnected graph. And if we consider about direction also, there also we can see like it can be a like a disconnected graph, because if a direction is present from 3 to 0 only, that case we can't move from 0 to 3 because the direction is from 3 to 0. So that is also a disconnected nature graph. So till now we learned about like graph, what is graph, the data structure, and what are the real life examples where actually graph is used. Then few graph related terminology, and then type of graph, like weighted graph, unweighted graph, and then what is the directed graph and undirected graph. Then what is complete graph and what is connected graph. So now we have to learn how we can represent a graph using data. As a data, how we can represent a graph. So for that purpose, we need to know two things. One is adjacency matrix and adjacency list. That we will learn next. So thanks for watching. This is the first video. Please follow all the other videos in this graph series. Thanks for watching.